Alright, we're back. Next up is the Melon Kingdom. Yoshi would absolutely love this kingdom. Oh my god, we are on the Ram Antelope Pirate thing. This is Iguanagon's realm. By the way, you can bust through these things now. And you can also kill these birds by having your pineapples above your head. By just running into them, you'll collect them automatically. And birds will fly above your head and you'll get some points for it. Kill them. Yay for killing birds. Okay, maybe not. I'm not a violent guy. But in gaming, I go for the points, baby. And, whoa, golden one. Oh, no. I lost my melon. That kind of sucked. And here is Iguanagon. That's that big critter that's been following you all this whole time. By the way, to throw a pineapple, just clap your hands. No big deal, and it's very easy to hit the boss, and yeah. He'll be back later, don't worry. Gold one! Yeah, 50 points! 50 points! Take that, PETA! And bowling! Oh, I almost got them all. Alright, jump here! And here's another bowling pin alley there, and that was pretty good. Oh, I should have took the high route. The high route would have gave me a lot more points than the low route, that's for sure. And those guys are very fuzzy and spiky. Oh my god, he's back! He's back! And he doesn't actually hurt you, so this isn't really a boss, to tell you the truth. I mean, he's just climbing up there, he's just having his fun, we're the ones that are invading his territory, he's not hurting us at all, so why are we blasting him away? I don't know, but if we do, we get a bunch of points for it, so let's kill him and just get a bunch of points, which is actually 100 points. Yay! And a bunch of bananas! Clap! Clap! Yes! Melon jumping contest, here we go! The further we jump, the more points we get! Yeah! How's it going? Go! And I got the best score! That was an awesome jump! Best jump ever! I don't know why I couldn't get such jumps like that when I was playing this game when I first got it, I don't know. Because I used to play this game a lot, but I got great scores for the long jump games. Next one. Oh, we're in spookiness. We're in the Banshee Swamp. There's boulders of, I don't know what the heck they are, magic flying all over the place. Maybe they're like meteors or something. But these follow you! These follow you like angry fish in Super Mario World. I'll use this to bounce up. Clap to get on the monkeys. Jump off. No! Oh, I fell into the blue fire. Which doesn't make much sense, actually. What fire is blue, anyway? There's no such thing as blue fire. And then we got a little kitty cat or critter or whatever the heck this is. We gotta navigate ourselves through the blue meteors of magic or whatever the heck they are before we fall to the ground because there's no wind gust to keep us afloat. So that would kind of suck. Go! Carefully navigate your way through here while avoiding the boulders or whatever the heck they are. I just can't figure out what the heck they are. I mean, that's like the weirdest thing ever. And bounce! Clap! And bounce! I shouldn't say bounce, I should say jump. Bouncing is when you jump off a vine. I mean, when you bounce off a vine after jumping. Oh my god, the timing's gotta be good. Yeah, there we go. Clap. You're gonna be stunned, and you're also gonna be dead right now. That was probably the most dangerous hog trap that I've seen so far. Okay, this part is really tricky. Watch carefully. You want to start out low so that you don't get hit by those blue things. Because what happens is that, remember, you gain a little bit of lift when you flap a wing. So by starting out high, it makes it exceptionally hard to dodge the boulders. Because you either going to hit the ceiling or you're going to hit a boulder. And you don't want either of them because you're going to start from the beginning once again. Stay with rhythm, birdie. Stay with the rhythm. Rhythm, that's why this is a jungle beat. We're beating ourselves through the jungle and clap here to make a bunch of flowers. Throw some bananas, which makes absolutely no sense because bananas don't really grow from flowers. Now we got to wall jump our way through this devilishly dangerous corridor, which we did with no problem somehow. Now we got to go up. Hopefully not. Take a hit. This part's very difficult. Come on, up on the birdie. Go, DK, go. Go, DK, go. And and it's gotta be a gap leading. Just go, alright, we made it, clap, and dodge, oh my god, this is scary. That was pretty dang good. And I'm gonna keep my combo if you don't mind. So I'm gonna just drop myself right here. Awesome, 154 point combo. And now we gotta kill this bird right here. We need to grab its pineapple and of course throw it up at it and clap. No. Oh, shoot. Did not mean to fall. Will I be able to get up? No, I will not be able to get up there in time. Drat! And clap. Oh, shoot. Why am I doing that? Why am I falling down the weirdest of holes? That's like the weirdest place to fall ever. And I was still holding a pineapple, I noticed. Clap. Oh, come on. Aw, oh, man. That's not gonna do anything. Come on, birdie. Throw it. Alright, oh, I hit the boulder. Is that gonna make him take hit though? Yes, it is. Alright, clap to go up there, clap to get on the bird, and slam to the ground. And now we'll be able to get to the melon, which is right there. And I've got a lot of points, I noticed. Bonus. Hyperactive Donkey Kong for the win. He loves his bananas. And his girlfriend Candy will give him his banana. Actually, come to think of it, I haven't seen Candy in a long time, since the Donkey Kong Country series. Where'd you go off to, anyway? Well, this is Bloat Hog. It's the play on the word Blowhard, but it's not based on a hairdo like a lot of the other hogs were based on, so I guess it's just based on fatness or something. But you know how these hogs work when they throw a... Oh, not a spiky one. I can't deal with the spiky ones. I should say I can't use a spiky one. Yeah! And is this gonna... No, he's up at the top. I can't do anything there. Clap. It will not hit him. Because of that upward platform, it makes it a little bit trickier to hit him. And I'm just gonna skip past that. Wait for him to jump somewhere else. Come on. Oh, not the spiky thingy. Oh, now he's back up there. Alright! While I was thinking about it while uploading the pictures to the computer, I think I figured out the boss. Oh, not that one, though. No, I don't think so. No spike balls. I hate the spike balls. The spike balls are the bane of my existence. Yeah. And he threw that downwards? Why did he throw it downwards? Yeah, alright. Yes, we got it! The object is to get him and the coconuts in a position that you can hit him back at him without the coconuts exploding on one of those two log ceiling platform thingies. Whoa. And evidently he can go up there, too. Yeah! And we got him! Oh, he's ticked off now. But that's okay. Whoa, he's going down there. And holy cow, lightning ball attack from all directions. Hoo-ah! Yeah, I seen where that was going. That's alright. Wait, throw it over here. Not over there. I said throw it over here. Lightning balls. Lightning balls are pretty predictable. They just go in the direction that they are in the circle, in the circular pattern that they're, yeah, like that. No big deal. Ah, I did that right under the thing. See, if I would have timed that better, I would have been able to hit him. Alright, go over here. No, why is he... This is gonna take forever. I might have to cut part of this boss battle out to fit it in one part. Yeah. There we go. Aw, man, I accidentally clapped twice. And that wouldn't have made the coconut explode then. And clap. Up. Yes! Now I can get up there. Wall kick quickly, DK. And kill. I think I only have to do this one more time. I really hope I do. I only have to do it one more time. Oh no, lightning balls. Here comes coconut. Yeah. Coconut! No. Clap. Yeah, oh, so close. I really hope I don't have to cut out this boss battle. I don't like to cut things out.
Yeah. Yes!
Come on. Go, go, go. Hurry, good. Hurry, DK. Go.
Take him out.
Yeah. That's the end of the stage. Let's quickly watch the ending video and finish off this diabolical part. 8-5 beast lost on that one. Poopers. Yay! Kingdom clear. That was kind of a disappointing boss battle. Usually I whoop his butt. I guess I could have flew through there, couldn't I? Well, that would have been pretty dang tricky to do. But anyway, that's it for this part. Hope you guys enjoyed it.